Hey folks, been doing a little more work on this 31 Frigidaire. Got the new cold control cables put in there. Those are made out of lawnmower throttle cable. And then the light control switch wiring for the magnetic reed switch is in place. That is the core of the pull cable. I made that core out of stainless steel welding wire. See how that works. Of course, that operates the spring on the control to set your pressure that the compressor cycles on and off at. And that big roll of wire will of course get trimmed off, but that is going to be the cabinet light cable that I ran through the back along with the lines. Totally concealed. So next time you see it, hopefully some more parts will be back on there. I know it's been a little while since I've had an update on this, but I've had a lot of other things going on, work-related and hobby-related. Had to work on this a few minutes at a time, and I just haven't been able to record it all. But you can see it's all cleaned up down here. I'm planning to put some more cork insulation panels in there to make it look like it did. But I got all the grime and grease and old crud off of there. So yeah, I'm going to move on forward with it. Now, I got this cladding on here, but before this strip in the bottom, breaker strip, goes in, I cleaned this edge up. Now I'm going to put a little bead of silicone in there. And the reason for that, when this is in place, if for whatever reason there's a major spill in the cabinet or a defrost, you know, water falls down here, you don't want water to go underneath the breaker strip and get in the wood. You can look at the condition of the wood. I mean, you can see a few places where it's been damp, but there's no rot, nothing decayed. And I want to make sure that I don't set it up for that rotting process to start because I was careless. So I'm going to put that white silicone in there. Use that. GE's competitor's product. Should use that on a monitor top. So put that bead in there and then seal it in. So I went ahead and put fresh sealant in these seams in here. Make it look kind of more finished on the cabinet. Now, so I'm going to go on and replace this damaged line here. You can see the dent in the top of it, kind of a reduction in diameter. So I think one of my friends said maybe water got in there and froze over and over again, and it caused the frost jacking effect. And once it had created a depression there, water would stay trapped and increase the rate at which the frost jacking did that. But either way, it's no good, so this is going to have to go. So I made a thing with no crushed in spot. It swaged on one end, flared on the other, and it will go on there like that and be soldered and replace this. So hopefully there won't be a restriction or a leak path. That looks a little better. Did a little progress on this Frigidaire. I showed the new line connection that I've created earlier. Well, I got that installed. I also have fixed these hinges so that they're shifted upward and that the door is properly aligned. Sadly, the original slotted pan head screws were structurally deficient, and temporarily I've put those in there to make it safe to keep the door on there. And I put a new spring inside the latch so it's not weak anymore, and a new door gasket. So I would like to have documented this with more real-time video, but the rain has been loud today. I haven't been able to video because of the rain. And as you can see, the light is working. The magnetic sensor is inside here. So you can see how that works. And then there's a magnet on the bottom of the door glued on. Kind of dirty down there, I gotta clean that. So this adapter is soldered on. All that stuff's tightened up, ready to go. Well, I couldn't resist. I put that evaporator cover on there just with a couple screws temporarily so you can see how it provides a shade for the light. The light shines out and it hits the white porcelain interior of the cabinet and shines down and pretty well lights the entire cabinet up. But without you having it shine directly in your eyes. Because especially with this up on a dolly, I can almost see it without ducking down. But really, when this is sitting on the floor, people are tall enough that light's not going to be in their eyes. But I'll demonstrate again the effectiveness of it. All the shadows. None of the shadows. You can hear the relay. Turn off the video light. Also, this the new handle spring, it's got quite a bit of force to it. You can see the gasket get compressed. That's just what you want, but it's not so strong that it'll damage it if the door gets closed without pulling the handle back. I always like to pull the handle on these just for not being hard on it, but this one, if it gets closed like that, it won't hurt it. So tomorrow, hopefully the correct permanent relay will be here for the light. I just put that in there to demonstrate. And it's going to be hidden up in this corner under a wooden cover. But as far as these hinge mounts go, I glued in, I drilled a 7/32nd, I think, hole. And I tapered the end of a 1/4-inch oak dowel and I drove it in there with super glue on it. And then cut it off flush and then re-drilled the hole. I took still pictures, which I'll post, explaining how to do that. But this is why I'm not reusing the screws that came out. Because nothing looked wrong there. As soon as I tried to unscrew that, it just broke off. And thankfully, there was enough of it left sticking out to pull it out. So that's gonna be it for now. Hope you guys are appreciating this. And I apologize, I haven't had more footage from today, but I'm trying to get this project done and I have other obligations at the same time, and there's only so many hours in a day. But anyway, thanks for watching.